And welcome, my friends, to the show that never ends. Come inside, come inside, come inside. Hey, welcome to Midwest Miniature Guys, Manic Miniature Monday. We're back from a short break. We didn't stream yesterday because I still had friends in town.
What?
A nerd that has friends? Yes, they even stayed in my basement. We were going to get some gaming done last night, but that didn't end up happening because, well, we're tired old people. That's why. So I hope you guys have all had a grand weekend. Nice, quiet. Maybe you got some gaming in. Maybe you got some painting in. I don't know. I don't know your life. I'm not there. I'm not in your heads. But anyway, I hope you got some. I hope you had a good weekend. And now we're going to get some painting in. We're going to continue working on our Pathfinder iconics. This is the Paladin, and then we've got the Cleric over here. They're going to be of the same religion. That's why I'm painting them in the same colors. So, yeah. I thought I did her eyes. Maybe I didn't do her eyes. I still have some. Oh, nope, I guess you just got some blue in. None of that, yeah.
No blue.
I'll find some ivory. That's bright. I want regular. That's bold titanium white. Where's my regular ivy? I want gray. Where's my regular? I still have it out? No, I don't have it out. That's yellow. Is that? Oh, that's golden brown. Where's my... There's my regular ivory. There we go.
I guess I had linen white out, but ivory will work here.
Maybe it won't. Nope. No. No, it just brightens everything up. Let's just go back over to linen white here. Yeah, that's fine. That works. Is that linen white? Yeah, linen white. But we played some cards this weekend. We like to get together and play a game called Shanghai Rummy. It's kind of like Phase 10, so there's 10 different hands to play through, and each one's are like, the first one's like two sets of three, so you have to get three of a kind, and but in two different groups, right? So you're like all threes, all fours, all aces, whatever. But the cards have points allotted to them, and the face cards are worth 10. So your Jack, Queen, King are all worth, or nine, are all worth 10. Your Ace is worth 50 along with the wild cards. Wild cards are twos, Jokers, and then you have your Aces. And the Aces are worth 50 as well. And you try to go for the lowest score possible. So far, the record is 55 points, held by my friend Eric Merlin. We call him the Merlin. And nobody's gotten close. I think the closest was 75. And still have not been able to beat him. Which, of course, he gloats over quite a lot. It's like, haha, you can't beat me. And we're like, we'll get you Gadget and your little dog too next time. Yeah, it's a fun game. Takes a little while. It's a long game. Because everybody's got their strategies and their stuff to do. And it's not just sets, so you actually get like runs and stuff like that as well, just like as in Rummy. So, you know, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Sometimes you got to get a run of 5. Sometimes it's a run of 4. Sometimes it's a run of 10. So, it's a little silly, but it's fun. Really strange. If this ear's bigger than this ear, it's really weird. Well, since I got the linen white out, I might as well get blue going here. Hey, my blue stayed mostly wet too, that's great. Got the wet palette actually doing its job. That I painted on the cloak here. Alright, that's all the blue that we've got on her, so we're going to switch over to this one. This lovely lady here, she's got a ton of blue on her.
We're just trying to make these tabletop ready. We're not going to go too crazy on it. At least I don't think I will. Let's see. We still got our shoes to do, too. Alright, we're gonna add a little bit more white in here. Normally I'd be adding in more of like a lighter blue, like a sky blue, but we had the white, so we can mix that in. No worries.
little bit left. Nice. Excuse me. So I'm just taking a little copper here and hitting some of the little other metal parts. I'm not sure if that's a metal part right there or not. I think this is though, right there. I think blue and an off-white and copper are a very cool combination. Silly Noodle, Noddle, hello. How you doing? I don't know if my sound alerts are working right now, so I apologize. I have to get them fixed. It's a little too bright. There we go. And I apologize, Silly Noddle, I read your name wrong. It's Silly Noddle, not Noodle. So I get for reading too fast.
See, she's a priestess, but she's a pretty, pretty priestess. Give her some little blue lips here and some eyeshadow. Except it's more like eye highlight. That. And she's almost done, so we'll move back over to her. That's unfortunate. Some of these original Bones models weren't cast as well as the new stuff is, and it makes for hard paintings sometimes when you're trying to do, say, eyeshadow, and you're getting like an monobrow cooking here. What I can do is I can do like a cool marking. She is a paladin. And then on this side will go tattooed dots. This looks like it highlights a scar. Yeah, there we go. Let's see, we've got the bow, we've got the sort of the scabbard and arrows to do.
just gonna go like this for the arrows. We're gonna grab a little bit of that off-white that we had there for the robes and such. 353 followers. Who's the new follower? Silly Noddle followed. Well, thanks, Silly Noddle. Keeping with our theme here. It's one of the reasons why I haven't grabbed any other paints is because I'm still using some of the stuff up from last Wednesday. All right, time to put some paints away here. So this is charcoal black. I'm going to try and actually do the pupils here. Normally I use a micron pen, but it is upstairs with some of my drawing stuff, and that ain't going to work. go. So also work for the belt here. We can even do our hair in this as well. Because we did our hair in all in pure black. So this charcoal, the coal black, I guess I should say, should help pick out her braids. Hey, Aldi, what's happening? Knight in white satin, yeah, you could. I was thinking she's more of a paladin. She's gonna go along with my priestess here. Ooh, Kyra, yep. Yep, Kyra, and try not to make her look cross-eyed. That's the other key thing here. Not bad. They just completely darkened that eye in. That's not what I wanted to do. Fix that. I grab a little bit of linen white. Just do get some of the excess. Ah, see? Screwed it up. Oh, very nice. The only Pathfinder that I have ever played, I played it, well, Greg, my friend Greg ran it, and he ran the Kingmaker campaign. Which was fun. However, he didn't run a lot of the actual kingdom building part in it. And then my friend Peter DM'd us through a little one-shot. And that was okay. It was fun. It was a fun campaign. No complaints. Wow. That's a lot of Pathfinder, man. There was a point where you could play 6 to 7 days around the Twin Cities at Pathfinder Society events on Meetup. That is a lot of Pathfinder. Speaking of finding your path somewhere, are you going to come to the surf show this Saturday night at the Acadia? Acadia. Used to bring my boys to play some nights, some weekends, so they became teenagers. Yeah, there you go. You should do that. It's going to be a fun time. We're going to have Gus the Bardic Troubadour and the Jameson Twins opening up for us. And then we're playing the rest of the night. We'll have to say that it's a $5 cover charge there. It's one of the only places that we play that has a cover charge. But the food is really good and they have a great drink selection, so. Think you're free? Have Pathfinder and Diwali party on Sunday? There you go. I mean, $5. Who doesn't have $5, right? I was doing white for a reason. Why was I doing white? Oh, I remember why I was doing white.
Do the arrows. Or at least the fletching on the arrows. Yeah, man, grab some friends, come on to the show. Should be a good time. So just add some platinum white to our cold gray just to get a nice kind of a cool warm brown here. A warm gray, I guess I should say. I don't know why I said warm brown. Gluing together some Ghana pallbearers to set on the side of the table to shock the players when they fight the tough monsters. There you go. Always good to keep those little buggers on the on their toes. Kim made popcorn. I can smell it from here. Gosh, that smells good. Jeez Louise. That is very true. Good popcorn is good, but if your kids burn oatmeal or popcorn, you can't get rid of that smell for days. That is very true. Epic Realms is on. Hey, Epic Realms, what's happening? You must be lurking. Mind in My Bubble, that's a great name. Shark the Noob. Shank the Noob, not Shark the Noob, Shank the Noob. And Vimix watching. Hey, everybody. Well, I had four people watching, and I started going saying hi, and fucking left. So Kim will either make like a big bucket of the Orville Redenbacher microwave popcorn. It's like movie theater popcorn kind of thing. Otherwise we have a carnival popcorn maker down in our basement for game nights, or if we want, or if we have like a movie night, we'll make that. And it's really good. Because we make it with coconut oil. We have all kinds of toppings. We got the nacho topping, we got the regular cheese topping, we got all kinds of toppings downstairs. We even got the butter flavored, extra butter flavor topping. Excuse me. I'm betting that she doesn't eat all of that, and then she's going to save it for me tomorrow. And I'm okay with that, because that'll be a good snack. While I'm at work. Sit for a little bit. I'm gonna grab some of the silver. We'll work on her armor. Yep. Yep. We got Kyra and Sela from the Pathfinder Iconics. These are in the old bones material, too, from the first Kickstarter. I all my days, my sight, my strength, she will guide my sword into the heart of evil. Yep, exactly. Just taking that silver right on the edge here. And then we'll put a little bit right there. Just to make that sword pop out just a little bit. Just a wee bit.
You can tell this is old bones material too, because the edges are not sharp at all. Try to do any edge highlighting when there's no edges to be worked on. It's all very soft material. There, sir. Brighten up that armor a little bit. Make that pop. I'll mix a little white and a little linen white in my woodland brown here. Finish up this bow. Well, not much more I can do on them, so finish up their bases is what I'm gonna do. So we're going to use some muddy brown, some brown sand, and some desert sand for the bases. try. Alright, I am going to mute my mic here for a second so that I can dry these off. Hold on. All right, that is done. Now for our brown sand. Desert sand. It's very wet for a dry brush. Just gonna grab this one here. Got a good amount of desert sand on there, and just go over it like so. Just like that. I think I'm calling them done. Well, not really done yet. Hold on. Gotta repaint the bases here. Make them look halfway decent. I'm thinking these two are going to be available at Con of the North next year for purchase. So if you want them, come and get them. Let's work on some goblins. Let's see. Grab some battle mud wash here. And a little bit of this brown. Bow. And the wrap on his boot here. This guy.
These are old Reaper Warlord goblins from their Warlord game. Buddy of mine gave me a bunch of minis because he wasn't painting anymore. And I said, thank you very much. I overpaint them. We'll use this for the fur too here. Just on his quiver. And the little rope belt. Oh no! Oh, we're all right. Okay. I'm just gonna pick this guy up real quick and do the teeth. Okay, and once again, I'm gonna mute the mic. All right, so now is when we go into our battle mud wash. And we take and we go all over the mini with this. Even the green, all the browns. Mmm, it smells good. That
this guy. Do the same thing.
So that gives us a nice starting point there. There we go. Let's see if this guy's dry yet. Nope, he's still pretty wet. So we will move on to something else. We can take these off the painting bases. On her. Work on her, and we'll work on maybe her. Yeah, we could do this dark elf. That might be fun. So we've got little mechanics with the big gun. Should be holding the wrench. Then we've got a dark elf priestess here. Good old spider sign there. Haven't really started on her except to put a little brown on the mace handle. She is so stupid skinny though. Like she has no musculature whatsoever enough to even lift that sword and mace. But let's see what we can do here. I have no idea why she is in rags for a cloak. That doesn't... I mean, she's a priestess, for crying out loud. She's not destitute. You know, not all dark elves are just in rags. And she's even got wrappings on her boots and stuff. It just, it's kind of dumb. That's why I really never liked these sculpts, but it, like I said, it came with the Kickstarter, so I kind of got to paint it. I'm sure somebody could do something very cool with this sculpt, and I'm sure somebody has, I just haven't seen it. Is that her hair? That's her hair. No, that's part of her outfit there. I'm almost using this charcoal, or this coal black, I keep on calling it charcoal black, but it's just coal black, as a, not a glaze, but almost as a wash, so I can pick out some of the areas here. That part didn't get primer.
Should I go total cliche and do the cloak thingy purple? Need a random color generator. Yeah. Yeah, and the thing is, I don't want to go, like, too random.
Doing that.
I'm gonna be getting like chartreuse or some stupid stuff, and I'm not doing that. We'll just work on the skin instead. Not that there's too much of that. Before I do that. We'll get all the random metal bits painted here. Since I have a big old pile of silver. Well, she's got a big old spider on her shield, so I'm going to say probably Lolth. Lolth. That's what I'm going to go for anyway. So purples and greens and such. Maybe some blue. But first, yeah, I know, some of that part is probably going to be a little fabric or something, but for right now. Just dry brushing the crap out of this thing. And don't get me wrong, I like me some drow. Okay, well, we can kind of see where the armor was at, which is there, there, there. Of course, there. Deep purple, shady blue, evil pink. Ooh. recipe for monstrosity there.
Law dogs, lawmen, and drawl. Yep, exactly. Hey, that's the other thing. If you come to the Acadia show, I can get you your minis. There's another draw. Come to the show. Carrot leads the horse, exactly. Alright, so this is actually dark elf flesh, so pretty perfect for this. That arm is so small, I can't tell if that's an elbow or a piece of the armor. Seriously, you see that? Look at how small, look how thin that arm is. I'm glad I didn't have to, like, freaking glue that or something. That would have sucked. We're not going to get too far into this tonight. But at least get the skin done. I'm not going to be doing a lot of mixing on this because the face is so freaking small. Yeah, I'm not going to try and do a spiderweb motif on the cloak. That it's just too fiddly. Two fiddly bits on that. I'm don't know. We'll see. Like I said, we're not going to get too far into her tonight. Probably pin on her more on Wednesday. When I hopefully have a little bit more sleep, which is probably not going to happen because on Tuesday I've got band practice, so I'll be out till at least, well, I'll probably get home around midnight. So I've got that going for me. And Wednesday we stream, and then Thursday might be game night. One of our guys is in California right now. So we might play. Had a wild idea. I'm gonna use a little bit of this mid-tone here for her hair.
Alright, well, it's been a day. So, it's 10 o'clock. I'm calling it for the evening. Hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your evening. Thanks for popping in tonight. I greatly appreciate it, as always. See, I can't even talk anymore. So, Vimic, Vil Mercy, Shank the Noob, Merxy, Mind in My Bubble, Lead Logic, Gamer's Ledge, hey Gamer's Ledge, Epic Realms, Miu, another TV viewer. Thanks all for watching tonight. I appreciate it. We're going to bop on over to, who's streaming right now? We are going to bop on over to, wow. Then we're going to bop on over to Maisie Lynn. She is doing Ghost Watchers. So we're going to raid on over there. Have a great rest of your night, folks. As always, happy painting. We'll see you on Wednesday. Bye.